नमस्ते. दिस वीडियो इज स्पेशली फॉर रिसर्चर्स, द रिसर्चर्स हु वांट टू राइट रिसर्च पेपर इन द फील्ड ऑफ एजुकेशन, स्पेशली बिगिनर्स. सो आई वुड लाइक टू सजेस्ट, प्लीज टेक द स्क्रीनशॉट्स ऑफ द नेसेसरी स्लाइड, सो दैट विल हेल्प यू टू थिंक ऑन इट. सो आई एम प्रेजेंटिंग एजुकेशनल रिसर्च पेपर राइटिंग. So, I am presenting my views. These are not final or these are not approved by anyone. These are basis of my experiences. So, you can just see the points and you think on it and you produce your own knowledge. So, let's see educational research paper writing. So, what is research paper? A research paper is the shortest description of a research conducted within all minimum elements of the research. It means it should basically there should be research that is conducted and a report that is containing all the smallest elements, like all the necessary elements of the research, like objectives, sample, design, research type, data collection, etc., etc. So for this presentation, I have assumed that you know the basic concept in research because I have not explained it in this video. For saving the time. First, what is the steps of research paper writing? First, you need to define a problem, like define the subject, the population, and the variables. Suppose you want to focus on students' skills of drawing a diagram in a mathematics. Then you decide the standard, you decide the board that students are studying. So define the problem with all the variables, then review the related literature, two kinds of related literature, one is online and second is offline. So go through some MPhil PhD thesis, MEd thesis, and also go for the research articles published on various e-journals. Also go for the Shodh Ganga and other storage of the research papers. Then you refine your research outline, like define the objectives, final the operational definition, decide the tools, then conduct a research. So basically, if you want to write a research paper, you need to conduct a research, you need to organize the research. So that is the whole process of research. Then write a detailed report of a research conducted. Research paper is the shortest form, but otherwise, whenever you conduct the research, you write a detailed report of it. So once the whole research report is written, then you make a research draft as per the requirement mentioned in the conference or for the journals. The draft should be discussed later on with the experts and peer or your teacher or your guide or your friends. So have some suggestions about it. Then finalize it, prepare a presentation on it. If you are going to present it in the conferences, then you need to prepare a presentation on it. So prepare a presentation and then type it according to the requirement of the conference and then send it. So mainly there are two purposes of the writing the research paper. One is to present in the conference, a second to publish in somewhere online journal. Remember, but you should conduct the research to write the research paper. When you are writing it, there are many formats available on internet or even on the universities. Broadly, I have just defined those into the five sections of the research paper. First is title. Mention the title first, then mention the authors, your name and your institution name and email ID. Then write an abstract, a gist of it. Sometimes it is mentioned, the word limit are mentioned 100 or 200 words. Remember, it should be in the passage form. Then write the keywords. keywords like you can mention the variables you have taken for the research, and then start the full paper. In the full paper, there should be at least 6 things. You can divide into various different headings, but I have divided a research paper into 6 main points. First is rationale. So initial part should be explaining the need and importance of the topic that you have selected. Second point, that should be research framework. So the objectives, scope, limitation, delimitations, research tools, and sampling, and operational definition. All these research structures should be mentioned in the research paper. Then inquiry, actual implementation of the research should be mentioned under the inquiry terms, like how did you implemented research, how to validated the programs, or how you validated your research tools, how you collected the data, and data analysis should be mentioned in the inquiry. Conclusion should be as per the objectives or the research question you mentioned. At the end, there should be a proper discussion of the relevance of your research. That is very important in the research paper, because you need to justify your research, you need to show your research how it is important to contribute to solve some issues that is relevant to day-to-day education life. And at the end, there should be a references. So I think in your research paper, these 6 elements should be there. You can arrange it as you want. You can add some more points. So basically, this is the structure. This should be the structure of the research paper. So these 6 things should be included in any research paper. So what are the criteria for the best research paper? When you are writing a paper, you should care about few of the things. I am going to mention it. So if possible, you can take the screenshot of this criterion. These criterion are not recommended by anyone. I am going to present it as per my understanding. It may be you may add some things, or you may edit something, or even you can deny something. If you have any more suggestions for the criteria, you can mention in the comment section of the video. So this list is exhaustive. You can add it or you can modify it. I found on the internet there are different types of research criteria. There are no uniformed research criteria, best research paper criteria I found. Here I am presenting some of those. First, when your research is coming for the assessment as a best research paper, so as a guide, I need to find out how relevant the paper is. Is it relevant to particular theme or sub-theme? Those are mentioned. Second thing, whether that, how you have justified your selection of particular topic, particular research title, and how that is useful to the solving any issue. Focus on main variables. So because it's a short research, it's a small research, so you need to focus on your variable that you have selected. If you are solving some problems of students in geometry, so that variable should be clarified and that should be tackled only. And the same variable should be carried from objective to the implementation of the program to the result. So your focus should be always on the variable, dependent variable and independent variable. Optimum review of related literature should be done. There should be inclusion of articles, research papers, and dissertations and thesis. You also need to have some online resources and offline resources. Fifth, clarity of research methodology. You need to mention clearly in your research paper about the objectives, the sampling, the research method or the type of research that you have taken, research tools, how they have developed. 6, validity and reliability of the data collection tools that you have developed. You need to mention what methods you have adopted, and in short, how you validate or test their reliability, what methods you adopted. You don't need to give the data of the validity and reliability testing of the data collection tool, but you need to mention the method that you adopted for validity and reliability of the data collection tool. Also need to mention the procedures of it, how you selected the sample, how you collected the data, what methods you adopted, what sampling you adopted. 7, quality of data analysis and use of statistics. You know there are types of data, and according to types of data, there are types of research statistics. So whether you have selected a proper statistic to analyze that particular data will be examined when you are submitting your paper for best research paper competition. Then 8, research result, findings or conclusion with the evidences. So your results and or findings or conclusion should be related with the objective, research objective, and also it is related with the research questions you raised in the first section of the research paper. So it should be related with it, and you need to prove it. You need to give the evidences on what basis you have taken the, you concluded the thing. So refer the data collection and data analysis tables over here for the conclusion. Use proper research terms in the whole research paper. There should be clarity in the language. Instead of writing it in the first person singular, write it in the third person singular, and or write it in the passive form instead of using the active form. And the integrity of the paper, the whole paper should be integrated. So whatever information or the you have mentioned in from, it should be carried out similar to 1-2 up to the last part of the research paper. Mention the bibliography and references. References, if you are taking something, quotations or definitions as it is, so give the references of it, give the proper numbering to it, and also mention the bibliography that you have studied for particular research paper. Also, your the plagiarism status of your research paper will be checked by online tools, and if it is good, then it will be considered as a best research paper. For each conference or each research journal, they do have some criteria that how much plagiarism would be considered. So you just go throughout it and see it. And finally, the technical part of the research paper, like the font size, paper size, all it is mentioned in the generally it is mentioned always in the brochure of the conferences or the websites of the e-journals. So refer it and write according to it. When you are writing, write the precise abstract that is very required, and give the representative keywords, especially the variables on what you are focusing. So at the end, your critical approach should be reflected in the research paper. So use the scientific language and be a critical and be a rational in all the paper. So in this way, you can write a research paper with the help of these points. I know you need to understand a few of the concepts in research. So for that purpose, I have made another video on it to understand various concepts in the research. So use this research-based video to prepare your best research papers. Thank you.